guys, I am Minerva Tripathi. Welcome you in another video of All Subjects with Sandeep. In this video, we will discuss about a very important chapter of chemistry, that is matter in our surrounding. In this video, we shall discuss about two main topics of this chapter. Those are what is matter and what is the composition of matter. When we read this chapter, the first question which arises in our mind is that what is actually matter or what is the definition of matter? Everything that surrounds us is matter. The air we breathe is matter. The water we drink is matter. The trees around us are matter. The buildings around us are matter. And even we are also matter. In simple words, anything that has mass and occupies space is termed as matter. Matter is found in three main states: solid, liquid, and gas. We shall discuss about these three states of matter in our next video, because in this video we are discussing about definition of matter and composition of matter. Let's move further towards the composition of matter. In ancient time, it was believed that matter is made up of five elements known as panch tattva. These five elements were Agni, Vayu, Jal, Prithvi and Akash. But later on, it was discovered that matter is made up of a very small particle, that is an atom. And an atom is also known as particle of matter. It cannot be seen with our naked eyes. Now, let's discuss about the properties of these particles of matter or atoms. The first property of particles of matter is that the particles of matter are very, very small. As I told you earlier, we cannot see these particles of matter with our naked eyes. The second property of particles of matter is that they have a space between them. You must have noticed that when you add one spoon of salt or sugar in water, then the level of water remains same because the particles of water have a space between them. The third property of particles of matter is that the particles of matter are continuously moving. When you add one spoon of salt in water and do not stir it, still the salt will dissolve in water. Why does this happen? This happens due to the continuous movement of the particles of matter or water. So by the movement of particles of water, the salt gets dissolved into the water. The fourth or the last property of particles of matter is that the particles of matter attract each other. There is a force of attraction between the particles of matter. The force of attraction of particles is highest in solid and lowest in gas. So this was my video, and I hope that you must have get some help with this video. So please like the video and follow my and subscribe my channel to get more videos like this. And in our next video, we will discuss about the three states of matter, which are solid, liquid and gas. Till that, bye, have a nice day.